Hey guys, it's Alice. So today I'm going to walk you through some basic tips for Adobe Illustrator and the pen tools. So let's get straight into it. So first of all, I am using my Wacom tablet and the pen that comes with it. I'll leave everything that I use linked in the description below. And here I have Adobe Illustrator. I have the Adobe Creative Cloud subscription. So I've opened Illustrator, and just for this purpose, we're just going to use an A4 file. So I've just pinched to zoom. I use an Apple MacBook, so my trackpad lets me pinch to zoom. So I'm just going to make it the whole screen size. Let's get rid of this. And here is the pen tool. So the shortcut on the keyboard is P, or you can just click it here. And this tool here is the pen tool. That's what we're talking about today. So the first tip is the rubber band effect on it. So I know the pen tool used to really confuse me, and it wasn't until I went to university that I was properly taught it. So if you click once with the pen tool, it drags out a straight line. So I'm just currently hovering my pen over the Wacom tablet, and you get yourself a straight line. If I click another point and hold on to it, so I've not yet lifted up my finger from the thing, it creates this bendable, stretchy, elastic band line. And then if I let go, I have another guideline ready and waiting. So what this helps me do is kind of guess where this line is going to be. I can click again, and it's going to draw exactly where that thing originally drew. So this is how the rubber band tool can be quite helpful. If you want to do a curve, it kind of gives you an idea of what it's going to be before you've actually clicked it. And of course, if you do it wrong, you can just press Command Z or Control Z on a desktop, and it'll get rid of it. Another thing that I love using is the shift key. So I will click down as usual, and again, it just creates a straight line. If I hold the shift key, you'll see it will snap to either a 90 degree angle or a 45 degree angle. So I'm gonna do a straight line, and then I've still got hold of the shift key. Again, it'll just keep snapping. So you could do like a square or whatever. This is not gonna be straight. Or let's just undo that. So Command Z again. The same applies with the elastic band tool. So if I click and hold shift and then click and drag, it'll keep the little anchor points on a right angle as well. So as you can see, it's clicking into place when I've got the shift tool held. So here is a logo that I have created using the pen tool. I can go into detail on how to do this if you'd like me to, so just let me know. But I wanted to show you some keyboard shortcuts. So this tool up here is like an arrow without a fill, and then this tool up here is an arrow with the fill. So as you can see, the direct selection tool has a shortcut A. That's what you can see in those little brackets. So if I press A on my keyboard, it means I can pick specific points within this drawing and adjust them. So if I click this point, it brings up the, what are these called? I really should know this. I'm gonna put it on screen. It brings up these little handles. So if I have A selected and the direct selection tool on, I can adjust these anchor points by dragging them along. Again, Command Z to undo. If you've got a fine detail you want to adjust, so maybe this, I double click and drag, and it will let me drag it. It'll let me move these, and you can adjust it as you see fit. If you want to move the whole shape itself without affecting each point, you press V. So the selection tool shortcut is V, and this has selected the whole thing. As you can see, that little blue square, if you like, has outlined it, and this has selected the entire thing. This also lets me resize it, so I can drag and change the size. And if you want to resize it and keep the same aspect ratio, you hold shift like you do in Photoshop and any similar kind of software. So going back to just a blank document, I want to show you how to do curved corners. This can be done on many different shapes, but for the purpose of this demonstration, I'm just going to use a square. So here I've just drawn a square using the shape tool up here, and I'm just going to press A as the keyboard shortcut, or you can click up this arrow here, the direct selection tool. And what I'm going to do is click these little circles here. So there's some blue circles in every corner. So if I want this to affect the whole square, I just click once and drag, and as you can see, the corners are changing. They have rounded edges. And if I click twice, so now, as you can see, this little blue circle has an outline, whereas this one on this side isn't filled in. And if I click that and drag it, it's only going to adjust that one corner. Like I said, this applies on many different shapes. So let's do a star. So again, if I press A on my keyboard to get the direct selection tool up and go in, you can see every corner has one of these little circle adjustments on it. And if I want one in particular, just press the one, it gets darker, and then drag it and it will curve that one corner. And if you want to drag them all, you do just that. So let's trace something. I'm going to get an image up from Google, a very simple one, and trace it. What I'm going to do is press the P tool, and I'm actually going to change the outline of the P tool to something quite colourful. So now I've changed the outline to red, I'm going to outline this. Illustrator actually creates its own layers, so it's not like Photoshop, you don't have to keep going into the layers panel to create a new one, it does it automatically. So I'm just going to click in this bottom corner and click on the corner. And then if I click and drag, I can pull this band around, this elastic band, and match it to this. So again, if I click and drag, it leaves me with this rubber band. And if I click this square where it originates, it gets rid of that kind of anchor point and lets me do my own adjustments to it, like so. And then you would just click. So again, this is pointing me in the wrong direction, so I'm going to click it and just go straight back down here. So if I wanted to adjust this and make it a little bit neater, you can go in, you can press the A button on your keyboard or click the direct selection tool, and this brings up the different anchor points and the different adjustments. So it does look a bit rubbish, not the best work I've ever done. So let's give it a little bit of fine tuning. So I want to adjust the angle of this so it matches this corner. So as you can see, you can either curve it because you've got the little circle notion there and it'll kind of smooth off that point, or I can click this handle here and drag the shape of it and adjust it how I like. Another tip, when you're adjusting these points like this, you'll see that when I'm dragging one, the other one moves as well, kind of in unison with it. So if you're just wanting to adjust the one, if you hold the Alt key and click it, it will only allow you to adjust that one that is under your mouse. So those are my tips for Illustrator and the pen tool, just to get you started. I do recommend downloading a very simple image of some sort and tracing it, practicing the lines and how you use the pen tool. It does take practice, it is frustrating, but I promise you will get there. Watch out for more tutorials on this channel. I'm also currently in the process of updating my website. It's going to have free tutorials, freebies, templates, and loads of fun, different exciting things. So if you would like to join the mailing list to be the first to know when that goes live, that'll be linked in the top line of my description. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully it helped. Let me know your tips down below, and I'll see you soon for another one. Bye.